So, there you are, alone on one of the first weekends of the year. Aren't you pathetic? So you're browsing Steam, doing the annual look in the free games category to find something fun, activity. Maybe you're in a boy chat too with a group of friends, or who knows. But then, unfortunately, you find about this game. War Robots, I mean, Brawlhalla. Ooh, what's this? You click on it, discover it's one of those Smash clones, but for poor people, and then you install it, give it a go, you know, the usual. You play with your friends, have a nice free-for-all, yada yada yada, and then the next day you find yourself opening the game again by yourself. Yeah, I know, crazy. At this point you're too far in, so there's no turn back. So in this video, I'm gonna teach you how to get into the game and its community if you so desire. There's much to do, so let's get started. I am not gonna teach you on how to play or get better at the game, but I'll tell you the best places to improve if and only if that is what you want. As you may know, Brawlhalla is a platform fighter. It is not a Smash clone due to it being literally fucking different. Get that into your brain. This means the game has an ulterior objective, and that is to win, of course. Whether you face an opponent or you're playing with your friends, the game wants you to be on that first podium after a match, and that is a fact. We can talk about motives and what your objective in the game really is, but like, that's for later. The game has multiple modes divided into 1v1, 2v2, 4-player free-for-all, and 1 to 8 players in a custom lobby. They vary from casual modes for fun and giggles to the literal definition of despair, ranked. So let's talk about your position in the game. What is your ego? what is your purpose? Do you want to play casually with your friends slash family? Then the video is over for you, going to offline couch party and start having fun. Now for those who either want to play casually but still want to know a little bit more, and those degenerates who want to compete in any shape or form, continue watching. You wanna get better, you wanna at least know how to play the game, or you just wanna beat your family in the game, that is. First of all, you're not a prodigy, just yet, just because you beat your friends in Grumpy Temple with points instead of stocks. We'll discover that later. Because as of right now, there are people probably younger than you making a name for themselves and getting mad money. As I said before, I'm not gonna tell you how to improve nor the basics of the game, because that takes a video in itself and I don't know if I have the facilities for that. However, I can tell you a couple things to look for. Learn the most basics of basics, just the raw inputs of the game by going into the tutorial and completing it. Even if it's shit, for the time being, at least it's a foundation for what's to come in the future. When it comes to the meat and potatoes, challenges are your main focus. The newest addition to the game's quality of life are challenges that will help you get a more in-depth look into the game's mechanics. Just below tutorial, press the challenge button and you'll have a UI filled with tasks to do. Each and every task will have a difficulty rating and a resume on the challenge itself. Currently, there are 17 challenges with no order due to this feature being a work in progress. However, just like the tutorial, they are a way better foundation to start improving your journey. You click on a challenge, you'll meet your teacher, he'll do the required inputs, and you have to repeat them just like he did. YouTube, Twitch, whatever, the library of Brawlhalla knowledge is at the grasp of your hand. Get to know the very best players in the game and learn from them. Most of them have either a YouTube channel or a Twitch one, where they either stream or record videos in order to probably just entertain you, you know, the masses. They are the very best for a reason, so you should study them and know what their inner machinations are. Who am I kidding? They're just good, so you have to learn from them. That's it. However, have this in mind, even if they are top of the top, that doesn't mean they are the best at teaching you how to improve or what to do. They're not teachers, they're top players. What do I mean by that? Every top player has their own way of seeing the game, and as such, they all say different things when it comes to improving. Not only that, the amount of pro players who actually have raw info on improving are kind of low and scattered around. This is, of course, just my opinion, but there are very few guides that actually look like they took the time to give the audience proper info and good quality, so look out for that. However, my suggestion will always be to look out for the all-time GOAT of guides, Dorian's Ultimate Guide on Brawlhalla. It's got everything and even up to this day, the best piece of content ahead of its time. You can call it dick writing, but it's the only time I'll praise someone from Europe. There's also many, and I mean many, specific guides scattered around from content creators and pro players, and all of them will serve you just fine. Just play the game. The road to getting better at something is always to do that thing regularly, so your body inherently learns something new from it every day. However, we sadly have to share this world with others, so why not add them to the mix too? From Discord servers, in-game clans, Facebook groups, or even the most obscure of Amino groups, don't go there. You'll find a lot of people to talk to, play with, and even just argue, I guess, I don't know. You will never be alone, unless you forcefully isolate yourself from everyone. Some people are great, but others aren't. You must learn that that's not only Brawlhalla's thing, but it's also life, so don't put up excuses and talk to that person who you just had a nice set with. Making friends, it's important, but making rivals and partners, it's better competitively. Of course, if that is what you desire. Someone to enjoy the game with and also get better simultaneously is something almost required for a better experience, not only in-game, but anything really. That also brings me to my next point. This is gonna affect you one way or another, and it might be the most racially motivated thing in this video. Know what your region is. Depending on where you live, you might have a better or worse time either trying to improve at a faster rate or just finding people in general. There are 8 server regions, of which 3 of them are the main ones, 2 of them are the side ones, and the last 3, well, yeah. The main regions are North America as a whole, Europe, and South America. All of these regions have something in common. They have a big amount of players, they get the most focus in the esports scene, their communities have been a standard for growth and knowledge for most of the game's lifespan, and they also hold the current best players in the entire world. If you're in one of those regions, you're in a good place to find friends, rivals, and just improve your overall experience with the community. The side regions are Australia and Southeast Asia. They have in common a good chunk of esports support, some big names in the community, you know, also a growing community and game knowledge. They might not have as much players as the main ones, but at least they are known in general by mostly everyone-ish. If you are in one of these, it's gonna be a little rough, but you're fine. Now for the newest regions, Japan, Middle East, and South Africa, well, we don't know anything about them, aside of Japan, because Japan is big, that's it. If you're in any of these, I don't know how the fuck you found out about this video, but I'm glad you're watching it. My main tip for you guys are, continue playing the game, make friends, and start building a community which will be worthy of being acknowledged by everyone. As my last point for this video, there are a bunch of established and upcoming creators who definitely deserve your attention. They're gonna give you a good entertainment if that is what you want. However, content of this game is very basic. There isn't much variety when it comes to the game, so often you'll find content which can be seen as stagnant or even fake. Fake in the sense of the passion and the emotion just not being there. They show you a facade of what their actual emotions are, and that is a no-no. Don't worry, this will change in the future, hopefully. Because the game is very, and I mean very young. The game is just learning how to walk by itself, and is still growing, and so its community. Everyone, top players, casual players, content creators, community members, everyone is replaceable. And that is fine. Because as long as people like you, who are interested enough in the game and its community exist, the game will be fine. Let this be a goal for you and your friends. From someone who has 7,000 hours in this game, I can safely tell you, I am far better than you, unless you prove me wrong. So go on, my own Polish gem, go have fun, or suffer through rank. Either way will make me proud. If not, then fuck off. Hey guys, before I end this video, Happy New Year's and all that shit, woohoo, yeah. I hope everyone is doing good. As always, I'm not. Is that an excuse to not upload videos? Maybe. Anyways, I have a video in my scrap section, but I don't know if I'll complete it. It's about like 50-50s and all that nerdy stuff. I don't know. If I get motivated enough, I'll come back to making videos. If not, then I don't know. Just catch on Twitter or something and just playing. I don't know. Anyways, thank you for watching and have an amazing year.